Okay, now we are familiar with the various processes of fabrication of UPVC doors and windows, and also the machines associated with this process. However, as you know, for any UPVC plant, the capacity of the plant determines the kind of machines that the plant is going to use. So the basic capacity plant would be a 40 windows per day or per 8-hour shift plant. The next level would be 60 to 80, then 120, 200, 240, and so on and so forth. So if we have a 40 windows per day plant, how do we find out what are the appropriate machines by doing certain time calculations? Now, insofar as all the processes mentioned here are concerned, welding, cutting, welding and cleaning, these are the three most important processes. Out of these, welding is the process that consumes the maximum time, then cleaning, and then of course glazing bead cutting is another process that becomes a bottleneck apart from hardware assembly. So if we are to work with a 40 per day plant, let's say we go to a customer and he says he wants to do 40 windows per 8-hour shift, right? So we will first have to ask him what is the product mix he's doing. Okay, many times, okay, the questions that we ask, many times the customer would not have a reply to those questions. He would not be knowing what will be the product mix, what kind of windows he will be ultimately doing. If that be the case, then we assume a single sash casement setup and go ahead with it. However, if the customer says, well, I'll be doing, let's say, 60% two-track, two-sash sliders and 30% single sash casements and 10% fixed windows. Okay, if that be the product mix, what will be the scenario like? If it's 40 windows and he does 60%, so he will be doing 24 two-track, two-sash sliders, right? 40 into 60% is 24. If he is doing 40 windows and he is doing 30% single-sash casements, so he will be doing 12 single-sash casements and 10% of 40 is 4 fixeds. Okay, if you add this total up, it will come to 40. Now 24 two track two sash sliders would mean 1 frame and you will have 2 sashes, right? So how many members would need to be cut? You will need to cut for the frame 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 members to be cut for the frame, and for the sashes you will need to cut 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. Totally, you need to cut 12 members, right? So for cutting, you will need to cut 12 pieces. Okay, how many frames would you need to weld? You will need to weld 1 frame for the frame. You need to need 2 rectangles for the sashes. So you will need welding, this is for the 2-track 2-sash sliders, you will need to weld 3 rectangles. Having welded these, you will need to clean the corners. For every frame that you weld, there are four corners. So for three rectangles that you weld, you will have three into four, 12 corners. Let's try to see what happens in the casements. You have to weld, you have to make 12 single sash casements. Cutting. What's a single sash casement? You have a frame and you have a sash. That's a single sash casement. So you'll be cutting four members for the frame and four members for the sash, totally eight. So if you have 8 pieces for cutting, for welding you have 2 rectangles to be welded, and cleaning you will have 8 corners to be cleaned. I hope this is clear. And for the fixeds, you will have cutting 4 pieces. That's what a fixed window looks like. Welding 1 rectangle and cleaning. Four corners. We need to produce 24 two-track, two sash sliders. So you will need to cut 288 pieces, yeah. 72 rectangles to be welded, 288 corners to be cleaned. For producing 12, you will need to cut 96 pieces. You need to weld 24 rectangles and you need to clean 96 corners. For the fixed portion, which you will be producing 4, you will need to cut 16 pieces. You need to weld 4 rectangles and you need to clean 16 corners. So total pieces to be cut is 288 plus 96 plus 16. Total rectangles to be welded, 72 plus 24 plus 4. And total corners to be cleaned, 288 plus 96 plus 16